Hey y'all, if you're looking for a translation plugin that offers a free solution, I've got one for you today. This is a bonus video going out on my YouTube channel. Normally I'm doing stuff on WordPress Wednesday. This is Tuesday, I'm gonna launch this. I need you to check this out though, because it's a pretty cool plugin that has some different features in it that I've never seen before for search engine optimization when it comes to translation options on your WordPress website. So I'm gonna walk you through installing it, show you some of the bells and whistles. This is super easy. It takes 2 minutes to install. So stick around with me in the video, check it out, and be sure to subscribe, because every Wednesday I'm creating a video just like this, and sometimes there's even a bonus in the week. Some of the cool stuff, about 2 minutes for installation. They brag that there's 90 languages, you guys, 90 languages that this thing will translate into on the fly, just right away. It also offers you the ability to make some edits if you want to apply your own translation, if there's anything that you see that just needs some adjustment. It's a really cool concept. These guys put a different spin on things. So let's go check out how to do it. You're going to go to your WordPress dashboard and click Add New. You're gonna come over here to your search area, of course, and you're gonna type in ConveyThis, and you will find this one here, Install Now. And of course, we want to activate it as well, so we're activating. Brilliant, it's already there. I want you to notice though, right away, it says that the plugin is activated, but it says it's installed, but not configured yet, so we need to go configure it. Makes sense, we need to set some settings in here in place so that we can easily tell it what language we even want, right? So the first thing it says is, please log in to ConveyThis to get your API key. Super simple, and again, there's a free option for this. So we're gonna click log in to ConveyThis. You'll come over to a simple registration page. You'll fill this out, no credit card required at all, because we're gonna go into the free option first, and you're gonna click register. Once you do that, whatever email you put in here, they're gonna send you an email verification. So please click on that. And once you've verified your email, then you're gonna be able to come back and log in to just grab one little bit of code right here. This is your API key. We're gonna copy that. It says it's copied to my clipboard. We're gonna come back over into our plugin area and we're gonna paste it in there. Then it's gonna ask us, what is your current website language written in? What is that? And of course, ours is Texan or English. And then choose which language you would like to translate it into. Now the free version only offers you the option of translating into one language, but some of the pro versions allows you to just kind of open it up and let it be whatever languages you need. I'll show you pricing here in a little bit. For the sake of now and being in San Antonio, I'm gonna put in Spanish. All right, that's that. You're gonna see it being previewed here, and you're gonna see the toggle happening right here too. Oh, this is so cool, you guys. Super simple. I'm gonna click Save Changes, and guess what? Done. It's on my website. So I'm gonna come to the front side of the website for a second and let you see things. Oh, there it is already. Look at this. It's right here at the bottom of my website. And it's just gonna stay as a fixed footer on the bottom right-hand corner of my website. Now there's an option to change that location here. I'll show you that in a minute. But I want you to see how simple it was. We're gonna toggle to Spanish. Bum-ba-da-bum, there we are right there. Check this out as I go down. It's catching my sidebar. You guys see this? It's catching my sidebar. It's going all the way down, catching my H1s, my H2s, all the way down the line. It caught some of my text above this image. Of course, it's not gonna translate our images. That would be miracles. But look at all this stuff and how it's catching all the way down the page, beautifully done, even all the way down. Here's my call to action buttons translated, all the way down into my footer area, all the way down in my navigation in my footer, which is in my widgets. This is incredible that it's catching all of this on the page and done that quickly. I mean, we're only into this video just a matter of a couple of minutes, and we're already seeing this type of incredible result. So I hope you're loving this. Let's go now look at some customization you can do inside the plugin itself. So you could add other languages if you had a pro version, right? But you can also come here even in the free version and say show more options. And instead of the rectangle flag, we can opt for a square flag or a circle flag to kind of make it look a little different. We can say display the full language, display a short text, or without any text and just have the flag sitting there. And you can also change the location to be up at the right top of your website, which is pretty cool. There's some spacing issues. And it's also given us a really neat feature that I've not seen before, especially in the free option, to add in some Hreflang tags for referencing different languages of your website. It's incredible. So I'm gonna click Save Changes. Let's go back to that page really quickly. Click Refresh. Now my options should be back up at the top. Remember, now it's up here at the top and it's gonna stay fixed with me. Let me slide my screen down so you can see that. There it is, hiding up at the top now. Kinda cool. Very awesome, man. This thing has some bells and whistles to it, but let me kind of blow your mind on something for a second, because I've never seen this. Maybe y'all have, and you can give me some comments in the thread below and let me know. But I'm going to click refresh here, and it's going to show me on my plan that it's translated 1,865 words, okay? Because in their pricing plans, they do have it per word. 5,000 words or less is totally free. So if you have a small website, this is ideal. But look at the options this thing starts to give you. You can come up here to My Translations. Now, it's got my domain name in there. And if I click on the domain name, it allows me to see all the different pages that have been triggered by a visitor to be translated and into what language. That's a really cool resource for you to really start monitoring your traffic, seeing exactly who your demographic is, right? And it's also going to allow you to see how many views of that one particular page has been translated. And here's where I kind of just start to really get impressed with this plugin. You click on this, come in here, and it allows you to do those changes that we were talking about earlier. So if you know in English that it's translating just a little wonky over here in Spanish, you can come in and literally manually make some changes in there, delete, type in whatever you need. And click save down here at the bottom of the screen, and the translation is now saved. And that's the translation now that will display on that page for your visitors. So this is a really cool tool, again, that I've not seen. I'm loving this. Watch this though, you guys. Here's the translation for the meta tags. So for your description and your title, you can come in here and do the same editing. That's pretty cool. And what about this? The attributes for your alt tags behind your images and your title tags behind your links. That is phenomenal. So again, you can come in here and just manually overwrite anything, and it's gonna keep a library for you here saved so that it translates correctly on the visitor's page wherever they're landing. I'm loving this. Another thing you can do is monitor which of your pages has been seen more. That way, if you needed to delete a page, it obviously does not delete it from your website. I want you to hear me when I say that. Clicking delete right here does not delete the translation from your website. What it does, or rather, it does not delete the page from your website. What it does is it just kind of wipes the memory here. So those customizations that you made where you're overwriting the translation, those would be gone. We click delete. But what that does is if you have a page that you translated and it's not getting that many views and you're up against kind of your number of word usage and you want to maybe remove some pages that never get viewed or never have any visitors, then you can go in and easily delete that and allow the word usage to be applied to pages that are regularly being used. Here's one more thing, y'all. I hope you're staying with me because this one is worth you watching this video all the way to the end. What if you wanted to come in here and do this? Check this out. You can even come in here and go to one specific area that's going to give you an option. Check this out. Let's go back into our domain name, right? And we're going to say that we want to get the JavaScript. So click on this option here. I'm going to tell you why this is so important. So we're going after specific JavaScript. We're going to generate the code. This is the code that we would copy and paste. It gives us clear instructions here. Paste it before the end body tag inside of your WordPress website, and this will translate a singular page. So let's say you just wanted to offer a page that says Se Habla Español up at the top of your website. You click on that, and this is the only page on your website that is fully translatable. That would save you on your words. This gives you a very cool option to just be on that one singular landing page. So you could do that for multiple languages if you had a pro version. So if you're interested in doing this, I want you to be sure to come over here, check out their website, look at all of their FAQs. They have a lot of information here. They really want you to feel comfortable with using their product, testing their product. So that's why they give you the free version. I'm also going to give you a coupon code so you can come over and check out all the pricing and get 50% 20% off using this coupon code. So I hope this helps you. I hope you get super excited about using this really cool resource. And be sure to give me your feedback in the thread below on YouTube. I'll see you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.